This video is going to be all about building and installing Firefox. So this package I don't think takes as much space as the other two just installed in the past two videos, which is LibreOffice and Thunderbird. In fact, yeah, it's 4.3 gigabyte. I think this is the last of the big ones that we'll be building. So really I can just carry on and do the packages in the order that I would have liked to have done. Like I said in video, one of the previous videos, that I probably wouldn't have done these in this order. I probably would have left the bigger ones till last, purely because of the dependencies. Just the chance that more dependencies already installed, so there's less time building the dependencies and more time actually concentrating on installing the package. But never mind, it's only an issue because the space is a little bit limited, but this isn't going to be a problem anymore now with the remaining packages. So first thing I'll do is to download package. In fact, what I will do is just check the dependencies on this one. So we should have all of these actually, because this is quite similar to Thunderbird in the way it's installed, so I imagine the dependencies will be similar. Yeah, again, these dependencies, I think that one's different, but the rest are the same, so I'll just check I've got that one. Yeah, I've got that one, so that's okay. If you don't install them, and as it says, it builds ones internal to the package, and that just means that they might be out of date, possible security issues there. It means the build will take longer and it will take up more space, if that's an issue. But it looks like, looking at the names of all of these, we've got all these packages installed. So, yeah, I'm going to start downloading this. And download this patch to allow us to use Graphite 2 and Half Buzz. Let me just check that Graphite. Yeah, we have got that. So once again, there's a mozconfig file to create. So what I'm going to do is just create this while that's downloading in the BLFS directory. And I'm going to rename it to mozconfig Firefox, so that I can use it in the future. And it's still downloading that, so I may as well edit it now. And all I need to do is just read this. If you have a multi-core machine, all cores will be used by default. So they haven't put the option in to disable the cores, but I imagine that you could copy the one from Thunderbird and it'll have the same effect. So if you have installed or will install wireless tools, you wish to add a geolocation comment out this line. So we've got that installed. API keys, uncomment the line if you wish to use Mozilla location software. So let's use that. Uncomment if you wish to use Google's API location. So we'll use that as well. And uncomment if you've used installed startup, yes. Uncomment if you have not installed Pulse Audio, we will have. Or uncomment this if you installed AUSILIB instead of Pulse Audio. So, just check the logic of this. Uncomment if you have not installed Pulse Audio, we have, so we'll leave it. Or uncomment if you installed AUSILIB instead of Pulse Audio. Well, I think we've got both of them installed, so I'll just leave that as it is. Comment out the following options if you have not installed the dependencies. We've got SQLite, we've got libevent, Firefox 6.5 says WebP and ships an included copy. So we have got that. We've got NSPR, we've got NSS, we've got ICU. Do not specify the gold link, which is not the default. It will take longer to use multispace. Uncomment this if NASM has not been installed. We have got NASM. Cannot distribute it via if you do this. So if you are planning on distributing the binary of Firefox that you create, you've got to comment this out to not enable official branding. If you're going to apply the patch for System Graphite and System Hub Buzz, uncomment these lines. So we'll do that. Stripping is now enabled by default. Uncomment these lines if you need to run a debugger. So we don't need that. Disabling debug symbols makes the build much smaller and a little faster. Comment this if you need to run a debugger. So we'll leave that and do not change anything below this line. So I imagine it means these two health hackers report calls failed installs. I think we left this one working on the Thunderbird one, so let's just check that. So it's been commented out. Oh, and then all this crash reports and update is everything below this line, so it looks like they've it's kind of not quite as logical. So I'm going to disable that. It's supposed to improve. Comment this if you know your machine is not effective. Well, it seemed to build Thunderbird alright, so I'm going to comment that out. And then all the rest of this, I think we can leave. Okay, so that's something about Firefox collecting users' data. So I think that's all the changes we need to make. So the Firefox is downloaded, let's extract it. Just see how long this might take to build. So I'm not too long, perhaps no more than about half an hour. Okay, let's change into Firefox. So next we need to copy the mozconfig file for Firefox and call it mozconfig. Now we can run the patching to use Graphite and Halfbuzz, the system versions. Create these keys for the API. Invoke Python 2 script to compile the package. It says the above disables tests because they use a lot more time and disk space for no obvious benefit. If you nevertheless enable them, you can run a test by executing Mac G test. Well, I'm not going to run that because of the space issue. I would normally test, as you've seen, I've tested everything, but because of limited space, I'm not going to take a chance with that. Especially if I was going to use this in anger. But I'm not, so we'll just start the build. Okay, so that's finished building. Took perhaps a little bit longer than I would have expected given the SBU number, but it's built successfully, so that's good. Is it saying that we've got errors, or is it just giving an example? Pass. Looks like I did a few tests. Okay, so we should be okay to install it now. Sudo mysql on this. And then a couple of other things to do. Set these variables. So there's another desktop entry required. Should be it, so let's try and give it a run. Applications, internet. It says the application's been updated, there it is. Yeah, that looks like that's working. Let's try. Looks from scratch.org. Yeah, that seems to be working fine. And let's try a website that's got HTTPS running. Yeah, that seems to be working as well. So that looks fine as well. And that's it. So that's Firefox complete. Let me just see how much space it actually occupied. 4 gigs, so that's a pretty good estimate on the in the BLFS book. So let's tidy up. That's Firefox completed.